Hello. I thought it would be fun to do a little get ready with me. So I don't think I've definitely shared how I curl my hair before, but I don't think how I've done my makeup. So we're just gonna do it all. So buckle up. Oh, that's not right. So I washed my hair yesterday because that just makes the whole process so much easier. These hair extensions take forever to dry. So whenever I know that I'm gonna be styling my hair, like I'm doing my new arrivals for Love Style today. So I always try and wash my hair the day before so I don't even have to like worry about that. So I am just gonna put a little bit of dry shampoo in. I have played around with it. If I'm not going to the gym, I like to dry shampoo my hair the night before I go to bed. But sometimes I just feel like if I do it the night before and then I go to the gym, I know it's like a lot of people say it soaks up the oils. I don't know. I still feel like I need to re-dry shampoo it. So I just typically wait until the next morning and I just do it. I try and remember to do it before I shower so it has some time to soak, but that's okay. I feel like it's fine. And I use the Living Proof dry shampoo. This is like my nice dry shampoo. If I like want my hair to like look clean and good, and it is still clean because I just showered yesterday, but this will help so I don't have to shower as quick or wash it as soon. And then like on days where it's just like greasy, but I don't really care what it looks like other than not greasy, I usually just use Batiste because it's cheaper. But I know people say that that's not good for your hair, so I just kind of alternate. And then I always stock up on the Living Proof when it's on sale. So then I'm going to brush it out. So like I said, I have hair extensions. I have two rows of them. And I actually have a lot of hair. I have like four wefts in each row. Some of it is thin because it wasn't like from the hair that I bought, long story anyways. So it does kind of take a while. So I'm gonna talk through it and then I'll speed this up. So I go right above, where is it? The bottom weft. I'm looking in my mirror, so I apologize that you guys are looking at my side profile. So I go, yeah, right above the bottom weft. Usually I don't have as much trouble getting it. Okay. And then get this out of the way. Okay, and then I take my a lot of products. And then I take my Living Proof heat protectant. And I will just spray my hair. I have spent so much time, like almost a year, trying to get my hair healthier after highlighting it and stress causing it to fall out and all of those things. So I have a 1¼-inch curling iron from Amazon. I freaking love it. It's like $25 and it lasts me for so long. I had the 1-inch one for a while, and then once my hair got longer, I started using the 1¼ just for like some bigger, looser curls. So, okay. So, what I do is I take like 1 inch. I mean, you guys have probably seen a million tutorials, but here's a million and one. So, I take like a 1-inch section of hair. Sometimes, like, I don't try and really like I don't pay too much attention to like whether it's extension or real hair. It typically separates just because I feel like it curls better when I do curl it separate sometimes, but I've also heard other people say try and curl it together because then it like blends better, but I feel like my hair is just such a difference in length that I can't necessarily do that. So I take the 1-inch section and I clamp it like halfway down. I always curl away from my face just because I think that my curls look better. I hold onto it for like 8 to 10 seconds. I untwist it a little bit, go to the bottom of the hair, and then I'll leave like 1 to 2 inches out just so that way the ends look straighter and that helps with like that beachy wave look. And then I just kind of like hold onto it as I pull it out to straighten it. And I just like go, I always leave those pieces first. I just kind of, and then I'll hold it a little bit longer in the front just so they look like a little fuller. So like move it down, curl up. I've seen some people like be able to like pull and twist it and stuff. I'm not that coordinated. So like that. And Just do that all the way around. I'll show you my trick later. So like I said, my real hair, as you can tell, is a lot darker and a lot shorter than my hair extensions. So I like tie them back with the thin little clear ties just because I hate how like you can see such a difference. As my real hair grows, I'll probably stop doing that, but it works for me for now. And one thing I love about my extensions is that like I feel like my hair can be like super imperfect and it still looks good, and it just kind of gives like that beachy vibe to it, which is why I like never straighten my hair anymore, because if it's straight, I need like every single piece to be completely straight. So I'll be back. Okay, so I just finished the bottom layer and then I just put the rest of my hair down. Where did I just put this back? So now I'm going to spray the top layer with my heat protectant. Okay. And then I go in with my Revlon blow dryer. This just kind of helps give it a little bit of volume and like refresh it. Again, like I said, my hair's not really dirty because I just showered yesterday afternoon, but I just like to give it a little refresh. Also, this noise is annoying, I'm sorry. I use it on the low setting, and I don't ever use it when my hair is soaking wet. Like if I'm using it to dry my hair, I only do it once my hair is like 75% dry, because then it would fry your hair. So I don't usually like use it a lot, but I just feel like it kind of makes your hair look more voluminous, shiny, whatever. I guess I could have, oh wait, whatever. I'm talking to myself. So then just kind of the same thing. So now is like really where you can see my real hair versus my extensions. To clamp it, twist it. It's just kind of like a bend at this point, and then leave the last inch out. And that's what it looks like. I don't like when my hair is super, super curly. I want more of that wavy look. So again, I don't keep it on super long and then just kind of like pull it out. There's really no rhyme or reason or method to this. Just do what feels right. I'll be back again. Okay, now I have curled my whole head. They're looking very bouncy. And I take my Love & Crew hairspray and just spray the whole thing. Okay, so now I'm gonna let them sit while I do my makeup and let them cool before we brush them out. So now I'm gonna show you my makeup. The lighting isn't great in here, but we're just gonna go with it. Or yeah, we're just gonna do it in here. Okay, I am no beauty makeup hair guru. So this is just what works for me. So this is like my full glam do if I like want to like look nice. So first I take my primer. This is the Dermalogica tinted primer. So I take that. Sorry if this is really boring, guys. Oh, I should have music playing. I should turn the music back on. Okay. I'm the worst tutorial person ever. If you're still watching, praise you. Okay, and then I take my foundation. I use this Hourglass foundation stick in shade Light beige. This is actually like a little bit dark for me right now just because I'm so pale. I've been trying to self tan more, but I often forget. So My face is usually a little bit darker than the rest of my body, but I also just like don't want to buy new foundation because we're in the middle of a pandemic and I put makeup on maybe once a week. So it's like, is that worth it? Not really to me. So it is what it is. And I'm trying to get better at self-tanning. Okay. So then, what do? Then I get these beauty blenders off of Amazon. So I damp it and squeeze the water out. And then I take my concealer. I use the Hourglass concealer, this is Too Faced Born This Way concealer in shade Pearl. I don't like to use a ton of it, so I just do little dots and dab it in. I like to have it a little bit lighter than my foundation to kind of brighten up your eye, and then I just kind of like bring it up to try and just blend it all. And this is just what works for me. Okay, so just really subtle and light. I should redo this in a different lighting. If I were to go in my office, the lighting would be better in there. So then I take this translucent powder and I got it on Amazon. I just put it over where I put my concealer. And that's just supposed to like set it. Oops, spilled that everywhere. Okay, now I do my blush first. Shoot. Okay, this. I used to do my bronzer first, so I don't know. So I take this liquid blush by NARS. This is so terrible, I'm sorry. So this is the liquid blush by NARS. Corinne said that this is the Cur Holy Grail, so obviously I bought it in shade Orgasm. And I don't even do like a full pump. I take like half of a pump and I just start with that and I put it on my hand and then I just do this. And it comes off like really dark at first, but I feel like it soaks into your skin, or maybe it's just like once you apply everything else, and it's not as dramatic. I don't know if you're supposed to smile through this whole thing, but I do. And then I take my bronzer. There was another cream, like a bronzer stick that Corinne used on Allie's bachelorette party that I meant to get. And I was waiting for it to go on sale from Sephora, and then I totally forgot about it. I need to go back through our text messages. So I just use this butter bronzer from Amazon in shade medium, or no, shade bronzer. It's like very subtle. And I put it like right in line, maybe even like a little bit below of the blush, and I feel like it helps tone down the blush. And then sometimes, depending on what kind of mood I'm in, I will put highlighter on. So I will just do a little bit now. So this is the Becca Cosmetics highlighter in Champagne Pop. And I will just use my finger for this. It's really pretty. And I put it right kind of above the blush. All right, and then I will use a setting powder. This is Charlotte Tilbury in shade 2 medium. I was influenced to buy this by bloggers. And I'll just go over everything. And this also kind of helps tone down the blush because it just kind of goes over it and sets it. Okay, and then this process seems really long when I'm talking it through, but it usually takes no time at all. Eyebrows next. So I got this in my FabFitFun box that I've been using, Winky Luxe Unibrow. It's like one shade universal brow pencil, not unibrow. So I just kind of brush my brows. I feel like penciling in your eyebrows makes such a difference that you didn't even know you needed until you started doing it, at least for me. And I just go over my brows, and then mine are pretty thin on the end because of like my nervous habit of like going like this. So as you can see already, it's such a difference even just from a little bit. And then I feel like if it is a little dark, I just kind of like blend it in. And that helps kind of tone it down. See, like that makes such a difference. And I obviously have eyelash extensions, so I'm skipping the top lash mascara. I do need to brush them out, but I need to find an eyelash brush. I don't know where one is. So then I just put mascara on my bottom lashes. I've been using this Thrive Liquid Lash Extension mascara. My mom gave it to me. I really like it because the bristles are like really thin, if you can see. And I just feel like that does a good job of getting the bottom lashes. I never used to wear bottom mascara, but I feel like it makes such a difference, especially because I don't typically wear any eyeliner anymore, because the lash extensions like make your eyelid look darker. This is almost out. I need to get a new one. I'll honestly probably just like look at Target or Amazon and get one with a thin bristle. Is that a word, bristle? So you can just kind of see the difference. Like, yeah, I really need to brush my lashes. But this eye looks so much better with just a little bit of color to it. Okay. So boom. Maybe put a little bit more. Okay. It's like a little lighter still on the side. Whatever. So then, I don't always wear a lip just because it's kind of annoying with wearing a mask now. It like isn't impossible, but might as well today. So I use pretty much the same combo every time because I like it. I use this NYX lip liner in shade Nude Suede Shoes. I'm terrible at lining my lips, so I know people say to like overline them. I don't do that. I don't know how. Oh, without looking like a clown. hard to do it on your phone, Karen. And then I just fill it in because I feel like that helps the lipstick stay on. So, super subtle. And then my favorite is this MAC Influentially, why is that hard to say? It powder lipstick. It's like a nude with a little bit of a pink tone. It's pretty creamy, so I do say I do have to reapply it, like especially if I eat or something, or if I'm like rubbing my lips together a lot, but I think it's really pretty. And it's just like a good nude. It's like the only lip that I can wear. So, I think that's all my makeup routine. So now, this is too loud. So now that I did my makeup, we're going back to hair. So now I'm going to just brush my curls out gently to kind of loosen them up and soften them. So if you want to see the difference, like that's brushed out and they do look even like better as they sit too. And then so now they are nice and soft. And then at this point, I'm going to get one of the clear hair ties. This is getting so long. Well, I guess I need to fix that piece. I get one of these little clear ties and I'm going to tie my real hair back just because I guess you can't tell as much right now, but like I hate these pieces and if you curl them, they just like don't blend in well and to my liking. So I just kind of like line that bottom weft. I don't know if you can see it. And then, so this is all my real hair here. Can you see? I don't know. And so I got my little rat tail. And then pull this down. And there's like this piece here, but otherwise you can't see those little baby pieces anymore. I don't even know where that other hair I needed to curl was. So now I would go in and touch anything up that I needed to. The thing that I love about my extensions is that it holds curls for so long. And if I wanted to wear it down, I would touch it up. But if I'm just gonna like wear my hair in a ponytail, I don't even have to touch it and it still looks cute, so. Okay, so I'll touch any other pieces up later. Last step. I take my dry volume blast, Living Proof, and I just kind of like push this up, spray it. Sometimes I'll lift here, spray a little, and then just kind of like spray it through the hair to give it some texture. Give it some texture and volume. And then if I ever feel like I need more volume during the day, I just kind of like scrunch it. And let's go in the light. So this is the finished product. I hope that was helpful. If you're still watching this, praise you, and I love you.